thanks a lot, Vernon. Thanks.
Thank you.
The Zigzag Project,
yes,
with Will Calhoun and Elvin Gibbs,
yes,
is the one you present here at Torino Jazz Festival.
Yes.
Which are the main characteristics of this project? Which are the elements that brought you together?
Okay. Well, I think the primary elements of how the Zigzag Power Trio came together is our long friendship and association. I've had a relationship with Melvin Gibbs going back many decades. And, you know, we played together with Ronald Shannon Jackson and the Decoding Society. And we also played in Defunct. You know, I was one of the alternate guitarists, you know, but Melvin is a primary member of Defunct. And we've been friends and comrades for a long time. He was the bass player in my first little fusion group back when we were in Brooklyn with Greg Barrett and Derek Baines, you know, and of course, Will Calhoun, you know, we're brothers from the band Living Color. And Will has an affinity with Melvin and the same kind of sense of humor, very dry sense of humor. And it's really a meeting of friendship and our interest. We were primarily affected by music of the 70s, like the 60s and the 70s. So, you know, what the so-called jazz fusion music, you know, the music of Tony Williams, of Miles Davis, Mahavishnu Orchestra, you know, all of those sorts of things, but also, you know, Ronald Shannon Jackson, Ornette Coleman, James Bud Omer, Sonny Chirac, you know, these are the people, foundational type of people, Art Ensemble of Chicago, you know, all of these artists were part of how we kind of came together. A lot of the tunes that we do, you know, we do a Pharoah Saunders tune, we do a couple of Ronald Shannon Jackson pieces, we do a Sonny Chirac piece, we do some originals as well. And really, it's the inspiration is the idea of transformation in music. You know, we came up at a time when music, like Coltrane's music, you know, Eric Dolphy's music, was about changing. It wasn't about you stayed the same. And a lot of the rock music, you know, Jimi Hendrix, you know, like that music was transformational music. And the idea was that everything, you come in one way and you leave a different way. And that has something to do with gospel music and spiritual music and what have you. Yeah.
Several times you crossed your career path with freeform music.
Absolutely.
Let's call it with jazz inspiration.
Oh.
It's one of your background and languages. What do you like especially in it?
Well, the thing about so-called free jazz, freeform music, is about dealing with the unexpected. The unexpected and the unintended is a feature that is baked into that music. And I would say there's a wide range of what it is. Going through I mentioned the Art Ensemble of Chicago and Air and all these wonderful groups, of course, Coltrane, but also with a lot of different artists have embraced it. And I would say even like the Velvet Underground, you know, embraced the freeform. King Crimson embraced it, you know what I'm saying? So, Soft Machine. So there are a number of artists, Frank Zappa even, you know, that part of the idea is that the unexpected thing is going to happen in life. And in a way, when the rug's pulled out from under us and when everything else is going sideways, you have a place to deal with it, because when it goes sideways, it's not so much about the trauma, it's about what do we do next? What do we do next? And part of the ethos of improvisation from an African-American perspective is about dealing with the unexpected, about disappointments, things going a weird way that you don't know, and also taking advantage of things that if I do this, I turn that, then it changes into something else. And that's what I feel, certainly when I think about the game of basketball. The game of basketball was not intended for African Americans to. It was actually a health regimen. It was like for rehab, and it changed into something international. And it changed into something that is. It wasn't intended to be what it became. So that's a kind of framework that the free form has. It's. People think of it as self-indulgence or do what you know. It's not that. It's about circumstances. It's about playing and inventing circumstances with others from moment to moment. And that's what I have always gotten from Ornette's music and Coltrane's later music, and
You were one of the founders of Black Rock Coalition. Mm-hmm. One of these tasks was to preserve and to enhance the creative possibility of the artists involved.
Yes.
What's necessary now for this kind of issues with the great changes that occurred in music industry?
Well, the music industry is completely different than when the Black Rock Coalition was founded in 1985. The music industry, we were still selling things. It was still a concrete kind of form of capitalism. And now it's changed into something that we don't recognize. But at the same time, the growth of the social media experience, it means that there's a different conversation to be had. That's kind of the thing that I'm talking about, talking to the leadership of Black Rock Coalition. We have to bring younger people into it. We have to rethink the narrative. And that's kind of what I'm thinking about.